The next topic is thermal properties of concrete. Thermal properties of a concrete can be defined as the effect of heat and high temperature on the concrete. So normally whenever you say the thermal, so thermal conductivity, thermal problem, so everything is depends on the temperature. So that may be due to the effect of heat also, sometimes due to the hydration process also. These effects can vary and always vividly spread on the surface of the concrete. Through the surface we can able to feel the problem. Some of these effects can be scrutinized materially and some are quite abstract. So depends on the material properties, we can able to arrest sometimes that the effects, and some are still quite. So the thermal conductivity is a measure of the ability of concrete to conduct the heat. So this is the general definition. It is defined as the ratio of flux of heat to the temperature gradient. So this is the ratio is defined as flux of heat to the temperature gradient of the project. Thermal conductivity is measured in joules per second per square meter of area of the body when temperature difference is 1 degree centigrade per meter of thickness of the body. General definition as per your physics as you have studied. So the joules per second per square meter, so that will be the normal measurement of units. When the temperature difference is with respect to 1 degree centigrade per meter of thickness of the body. The conductivity of the concrete depends on type of aggregate. Yes, always the due to variations in sizes as well as the quarry, so it may vary. And the moisture content, that is an important factor, depends on the available of the water or as well as the moisture in the air. So the conductivity of concrete will also get automatically changed. Density of the concrete, so that plays a major role, depends on the compaction or depends on the materials adapter. It also get vary. So variation in the density also the conductivity issue. The temperature gradient, so vary again. And next is thermal diffusivity. Thermal diffusivity is a measure at which temperature changes within the mass takes place. So you know that with respect to the weight process, it is related to the conductivity by the following equation. Delta is equal to K divided by C into rho. So where delta is the diffusivity, K is conductivity, C is specific heat, and rho is the density of the concrete. So which is measured recordically as well as we can able to calculate theoretically, depends on the known values with the basic examples or basic preliminary tests. So this can be taken. So the range of diffusivity in ordinary concrete is between 0.002 to 0.006 meter square per h. So again it varies from types of the concrete and also varies on the conditions. Normal temperature it may vary, and so minimum and high temperature it may be higher, moderate conditions it may get varied, and as well as depends on the type of materials again it will get changed. It is as per some basic records available, we are meaning that with 0.002 to 0.006 meter square per h, it is for ordinary concrete, depends on the basic formula. Next is specific heat. It is defined as the quantity of heat required to raise the temperature of the unit mass of concrete by 1 degree centigrade. So basically it means specific heat is defined by quantity of heat required to raise the temperature. So with respect to the unit mass of the concrete, the common range of values per concrete is between 840 and 1170 joules per kg per degree centigrade. This is the normal variation, minimum to maximum range for all types of concrete works. The specific heat increases with increase in moisture content of the concrete. So it's a common definition. So whenever we are going to increase with the moisture content, the specific heat will also get increase, or it may vary. The coefficient of thermal expansion. It is defined as change in unit length per degree change in temperature. So normal meaning with respect to the coefficient of thermal expansion. It depends upon composition of the mix, again with respect to the material characteristics and material properties. The coefficient of expansion of cement concrete paste. So we have again some basic tests are adapted in the laboratory to use the expansion of cement concrete paste to measure the expansion of the cement concrete paste. Coefficient of expansion of the aggregate, which means some basic materials test may carried out for considering elongation properties. You may have studied in the concrete technology as well as in the soil mechanics. You may study the word elongation of the aggregates, so that effect may be somewhere there. For ordinary concrete, value is 9 × 10⁻⁶ per degree centigrade. So this is again, for example, they are mentioned with respect to the normal concrete range values. Again, it may depend with respect to the conditions. Scrutinizing the effect of temperature change. How to scrutinize this? Internally generated temperature change. So internally, so automatically there will be internal temperature variation. So at the time of concreting, the base may have some temperature, the top may have some other temperature. Externally generated temperature change due to some of the external factors. Resistance of the concrete to fire. So by designing the structures like that, by resisting the concrete to some fire condition, so after the structure has been occupied by the tenant or some other persons, while in occupancy stage, if any fire actions has been undergo, the structure should be resistant to fire so that it can be withstand the temperature effects. In many cases, you may seen in movies also, or you may seen in any YouTube videos also, with respect to fire resistance, and the structure should withstand, the structural elements should mostly withstand, so that the life of the people may save. So even CBRA Roorkee, they used to conduct many fire tests. They have the big chimney to conduct a basic fire test for all the materials, so that the resistivity and with respect to the temperature can be identified for the particular properties, so that it should be designed properly in way of resistance to of the fire. Internally generated temperature change, what are they? The reaction of cement with water, so immediately the hydration process started, is exothermic and it generates considerable amount of heat. You know that whenever we have a pinch of cement, put it in the water, you may feel some sound. Normally it can absorb in bricks. Whenever you pour water in the bricks in the field, you can, or when you dip the brick in the water, you may feel some sound. So that the hydration process also again same. So it is exothermic and generates considerable amount of heat. That is the internal generated temperature change. In larger volumes of concrete, the temperature may increase as high as 38 degrees centigrade due to this phenomena, thereby hampering the curing of the cement. So due to hydration process in large volumes, so large amount of cement may be there. Example, when you're taking of M40 grade concrete, example, the quantity of cement is 400 and above. So automatically the internal temperature may get maximum up to 38 degrees centigrade. So thereby the curing of cement may be taking place, may be delayed, depends on the condition again. Next is externally generated temperature change due to the external effects. What are they? As pavement slab cast in summer. Again, I said that in early video, I said that in summer, normally they used to cast the concrete very early morning or as well as in the late nights, so that the expansion and as well as the cracks develop may be get reduced. So the pavement slab that may be used in roads normally, we have studied that rigid pavement as well as the flexible pavement. So the rigid pavement slab, whenever they are casting in summertime, they may lead to settlement or leads to cracks develop very early stages itself. Retaining walls. So now retaining walls again, when they are casting, it is open exposed. The curing also they done with the help of gunny bags only. So the development of cracks is can develop early stages. So in the when the crack has developed at early stages, means it induces the strength factors very much. So that is another important point here. Repaired or overlaid concrete. So again, when at the roof level, we used to have some patchworks. If we are not adapting a weathering course, so we used to develop the cracks may be some developed. So we used to repair to avoid the seepage in the concrete. So the repaired work can be taken care of, or also due to external generated temperature changes. So it may also develop some cracks. High temperature in summer, that is unexpected temperatures. normally whenever we at the June month in Coimbatore we have early summer, so in June when you see in the top due to summer we may feel some new cracks has been developed in the top slab, so that normally happens. So what are the prevention methods? Providing suitable expansion and contraction joint as per caudal condition. Normally we used to provide some 18 to 20 meter, we used to provide some expansion joints, so that may be reduced in terms of some cases, depends on the structure. Even nowadays in compound walls as well as in compound walls using masonry works, masonry means CR masonry, as well as in the flooring concrete for godown having length of 200 meter length. So they are also providing expansion joint with a rubber material. In some cases they are going with respect to the concept in steel, like we can able to see in the bridges at the joints they may have provided some L section to with the help of welding and to place there. So like that expansion joints also been provided to arrest the cracks, at least it will not develop throughout the full length, so the particular portion can be repaired and it can be taken care immediately. Providing distribution steel, temperature steel with helps to distribute cracks and minimize the size of the cracks. That is the main reason. Providing quality materials and some specialized steel if you need it, so that it can be developed to minimize the cracks. What are the thermal movements in concrete? Due to heat of hydration of cement, atmospheric temperature changes, etc., thermal movements may occur in concrete. So whenever we have hydration process, so on the atmospheric temperature changes, so the thermal movements, so development of the permeability as well as the material properties, so there might be some the thermal movements may occur in the structure. Due to the thermal movement changes in shape and volume of concrete, it leads to causes cracks on and under the surface of the concrete. So again, the whenever we say that hydration of cement process, and saying that early concretes and late night concretes may reduce the cracks, but even though those conditions also the thermal movement, that is the due to hydration process and the atmospheric temperature changes, so suddenly it may start to rain and suddenly it may become sunny, due to drastic changes, so the cracks may easily develop in the concrete volume, so over the surface, and even sometimes we can able to clear see neatly very deep also. So that can be developed. The thermal movements thus thereby decreases durability and also decreases the load bearing capacity of the structures. So simple words, whenever we have a crack, we know that the structure durability is go on reducing. Even we may feel in some cracks can be seen early in compound walls due to settlement or due to incontinuity, you can able to see the cracks has been developed very easily. So like that in slabs, if you have cracks, means again it will decrease the life of the structure soon. So the thermal movements should be taken care, very important points to be taken care at the time of construction. So what are the preventive measures? Use of low heat cement. So nowadays all the cement companies are coming with the low heat cement, and they are having some special conditions, depends on the states. For Rajasthan they used to prefer some cements, for Tamil Nadu they used to prefer some cements, for where Kerala they used to have prefer some cements. So like that low surakshas, in ACC we can see that low surakshas, suraksha cement, and then some process they may mention about OP, we know already OPC and PPC, and nowadays we are having corrosion preventive measure cement also, and slag cement, so many GGBS based cement, so many cements has been developed. So depends on the climatic condition, we use to adapt the type of the cement to be taken care. And use of pozzolanic material so that it may arrest the cracks and it may arrest the seepage also. So whenever you are arresting the seepage, it reduces the cracks development also. Pre-cooling of aggregate and mixing water. So before concreting the initial work, providing expansion and the contraction joint as well as needed conditions, that is very much important. That right, caudal provisions are saying that some different condition 18 to 20 meter, whenever you need some basic points. Normally in walls they used to keep some chicken mesh for every 4 to 6 after 4 to 6 lines they used to keep the mesh, so that the cracks develop may be arrested in the particular point itself. So later stages, the crack won't develop. So like that, providing expansion joints may arrest the cracks at particular level. We are trying to minimize the cracks so that the structure may be more durable. If the crack develops also, that should be arrested within the particular limit so that the durability of the structure may withstand for some time. Providing temperature steel, providing suitable insulation cover, that may be basically clear cover, or after concreting, whatever we normally used to cover with polythene sheet, or to whenever the more drastic temperature changes, like start to hectic rain or start to heavy heat, depends on the climatic condition. So you used to have that proper cover. Post cooling of concrete by circulation of water through pipes embedded in the concrete. So immediately after the concrete has been laid, circulation of water through pipes embedded in the concrete surface. Resistance of concrete to fire. The constant exposure of concrete to temperature above 35 degrees centigrade will have sufficient decrease in the strength and elastic modulus of the concrete. So as per codal condition, we are the concreting temperature is 28 plus or minus 2 degrees centigrade. So whenever it is exposed to 35 degrees centigrade, will have sufficient decrease in strength and Young's modulus. So that's exactly same thing that happens during the fire. So major temperature, again major development of the cracks. The fire resistance of the concrete is dependent upon the fact that how much water to cement content it have and its heat conductivity. So the fire resistance will depends on about the factor of the water cement ratio, and it develops about the heat conductivity. Concrete made with siliceous material shows little bit change in color with high temperature, which is permanent. Even in some buildings at the rooftop, you may, if the weathering course has not done and the painting also not done, you may have to able to see that the difference at the floor level, sorry, at the roof slab level. So with the due to that high temperature, so it may also have some change in color conditions. Even in cubes, after taking the cube and testing, after you can take a cube, and if you, the cube is 3 or 4 years old, you can break it and see, you can see able to identify the difference of some portions of the cube will, the aggregate inside the cube will have some different color and some portion will have normal color. So that is also that effect made with siliceous material, which change in the color.